Okay, so first we have, today's exercise, what we are going to say is the proportional integral PID controllers. Okay, so PID controller is to minimize the errors. Okay. The control the proportional integral PID controllers to minimize the errors. Okay, what are the transfer functions we propose as the first order system, second order system, third order system? Okay. That is called as the error rectifiers. So if you introduce the proportional controllers and derivative controllers separately, okay, PID controllers, PI controllers, and PID controllers. Okay, there are five controllers to minimize the errors separately. So first I am using that thing. First we are going for proportional controllers. First proportional controller, I am going to say that P controller. That means proportional controller using gain block and controller block. There are two blocks out there. Okay, this is a free body diagram and this is a similar diagram. Both the things can be achieved with the help of a similar diagram. First one is a gain block diagram and second one is a control block diagram. First you are going to see these two, you are going to make an attempt with these two blocks and you are going to check the performance. Okay, so there is one step signal is there and parallel one error rectifier. That means error detector is there. That means it is called a sum. And this is a proportional constant, okay. And one fun we can take in the example for first order system, and they are finding what's the response is coming in the scope, okay. So step signal is there, and some signal is there. You can probably proportional constant, that is proportional gain is there, and 1/s+1 function system is there, and mux is there, okay, and scope. And parallel we are taking the feedback from that transfer function to that. Again, we need to compare the errors. This error detector comparing the input signal, comparing the signal from that step input, that is the input signal and the feedback signal, and finds error or not. If the error is there, it will be rectified by the proportional controller, okay, to achieve the stability of the system. So if you're going to enter into the thing, we have to select, first we have to select the scope. So if you're going to frequency signals, I am selecting the scope and add to new models. Okay, the one model is selected, open new. Okay, so try to maximize those things and again minimizing. Then we're going for step signal. I'm adding step signal. As like that, you add for ramp signal and parabolic signal and find out what the response is coming. And I'm going for max, I'm adding that. Again, step signal, adding the untilted. Okay, so then I added the scope, step, and max. And again, you have to add the sum also in that. Things. What's the thing in the file? And again, you have to go for gain. Gain. Where is the gain? Means try to type the gain. Gain. So I think it's three things that's coming. Gain. Okay. So to try to add this gain. Okay. So what happens if you come into the slide MATLAB file? So so many things are started. Okay, so here what happens, gain is there, max is there, sum is there, step signal is there. So there are two more step signals, you can delete it. We can go for scale. Okay, so step, you have to go for sum, so you have to add it here. Okay, and we have to go for onward, we have to add a function. Okay, transfer function. So 1/s+1, if not means try to find out that thing from transfer function and the search tool, transfer function. Transfer, oh, sorry, transfer. Okay, so I get first order system, so try to add this thing into the MATLAB file. I got it here, so this is the first order system. Okay. So what happens, straightly we have to add this thing to first order system, but what happens, since we know that already its error is there, so we have to add the proportional controller. Okay, so what happens, I'm adding this thing to here and adding to this things to first order systems. Okay, and probably max is there, max is in this kind of similar to max, and max is connected to the scope. Okay, again I'm taking the feedback response from the system and I continue to the SF, what's the output systems coming. For example, I'm connecting as the output signal and I'm changing this. So if you click the double click, you can change the plus minus. Okay, then what happens? So this comparator will compare, that means will compare the input signal feedback signal, find out the error director and the proportional controller. This is a gain. Actually, we have to change it to the proportional controller. Okay, proportional controller means I'm changing here as a KP. KP, okay, 3. And parallel here I'm changing as a KP. Okay, so I'm giving the values 3. Okay, so what happens? Try to fix that KP is equal to 3. Okay, and K, that means central controller. Okay, KP is equal to 3, and KP is equal to 2, KI is equal to 3, and KD is equal to 0.5. KP is equal to 2, KI is equal to 3, that is internal constant, derivative constant is 0.5. Okay, so try to assume those things for all the functions. So the KP is 2. So I try to change it as 2, this gain is 2, okay, and this is the things, okay. So try to run this thing, try to simulate this thing, okay. So what happens, having some problems, we have to, for comparison purpose, this output is not getting from this function, okay, and we have to check it with respect to input signal. So what happens, we have to connect this thing with respect to input signal here. What happens? Yes, you can able to compare this what's input signal, what's output signal getting from this function, transit function. The first order system respect to the minimum with respect to proposing the proportional error constants. Okay, so try to run the simulation. Okay, and find out what's the scope. Try to click the scope. We can able to find the response. Okay, go to out of it. Then this is the response. This is the input signal what we're getting here. Okay, if you're introducing the proposal constant, we're getting the graph like this. Getting the graph like this. Okay. So the same thing. Okay. So same thing. I'm changing as like this. As like this. This is a gain block diagram. This is a gain block diagram. Okay. So as like this, we can go for this. This is what I think the purpose is for, only proportional controller. If you're going for PI controller, okay. So that means PI controller including the proportional controller, derivative controller. Okay. So always what happens if you're going for the proportional controller, okay. Okay. This is a combination of a proportional and integral controller. Here what happens? KI is equal to KP into KP by JI. That means J indicates yes. Respect to function systems indicates yes. S is equal to J omega. Always you have to replace the Laplace transformer, the transformer is a Laplace operator respect to J omega. So what I am saying that here KI is equal to KP in divided by J. That's the thing you are saying, that KP is keeping here. Always it should be proportional to the signal, input signal. So I am keeping KP is there. And finally what happens? 1 by S. That means integrator function is there. And I am fixing KI. KI is equal to KP into 1 by J. Okay. So we can make an attempt with respect to this thing. We have to add the KP and 1 by S. Okay. Yeah. So before going to this internal controller, first we can see this thing in the... First you can see the proportional controller with respect to controller block. So first what are the things you are seeing is a gain block. First you go to the controller block. If you go into controller block, try to replace this gain separately. And we are having the separate function is called as the PID. Okay, PID controller. So this is a PID controller, what you get it from that MATLAB tool. Try to add it to that file. And what happens? Yes, PID controller is there. Try to fit it here. Okay, again I'm replacing that. So PID controller. So what happens, since you're using the proportional controller, we have to change the K into proportional controller. Okay, so go to here, it shows indicates the PID controller. We have to change it, fit into proportional controller. Okay, so yes, we got it, proportional controller. Okay. So this is a proportional controller. Again what happens, so try to click the proportional controller again. I already say that proportional value is KP is 2. Okay, KP, the value is gain of that K proportional controller is 2. Okay, since it indicates the PID controller, it only indicates a PS controller, that means proportional controller. And try to simulate these things and find out what the response is coming. Same response we will get it with respect to the controller gain block. See, this is the input signal, and what our output is getting is the proportional controller. So, okay, similarly, we have to follow the same thing for the proportional internal controller, that means gain block. Okay. As like what I am showing this block diagram, what happens, the same block diagram, we have to add the KI, again one more gain, KI, and we have to give the values 3 and 1 by S, that means 1 by S integrated function, and we have to add one more summing point, Okay, so one more summing point here, and we have to find the what's the response for this gain block. Okay, now similarly, the same thing will get it with respect to this controller. Okay, so what happens? This is the thing. So what I'm replacing instead of the gain block. Okay, so for purpose controllers, if you're going for the okay, I will come to the next slide. Before going to the next thing, I'm changing the same thing here. P controllers, then internal controller. Go for internal controller. Okay, I mean, first I explain all the first I explain in this block diagram with respect to the okay controller blocks. After that, we will come for the gain block. Okay, so what happens? The controller block is same. So what happens? I am changing internal controller. Okay, internal controller. The response is coming. Okay, we have to change the values. KIE is always should be 3. For example, I am fixing that KP is 2, proportional value is 2, internal value is 3, and derivative value is 0.5. Okay, I am simulating is, I am finding the scope, what's the scope is coming out of it. Yes, it's somewhat the signal starting so to some level up to scale 1, up to 1 frequency. Again, it's coming to the jump to higher level. Again, it's coming like this. Okay, and finally, it's getting coming like a at one instant. What happens? Coming to steady state response. Okay, this is a rise time, that means price time, peak time. Okay, rise time, peak time, and somewhat comes taking settling time. Okay, this is settling time. Okay, so if you're going to derivative proposal controller, the signal comes within this level. Going for internal controller, it goes beyond that level. At one instant, you'll get the steady state response. Okay, so okay, so now we can go for the PI controller. We can able to find what's the difference between the proposal controller, internal controller, and now we go for PI controller. Okay, so what happens here? Proposal control value is 2, internal value is 3. Okay, that means KP, KI value is 3. Okay, it indicates PI, it in controller. Try to simulate it and find out what's the response is coming out of it. Yes, it's somewhat near. That means there's again the peak the rise time, peak time, settling times is happened here, and again it touches it in the same level. Okay, this is the response of the PA controller. Okay, so the error is coming, there will be rectified at this time, at this instant only. This is settling time. Okay, so if you come into again here, try to change the these things with PID PD controller. So derivative controller, always I said that 0.5. For example, I am saying that. Okay, so what happens here? So you get the graph like this. Okay, so what happens if you check the scope? That means output of the signal. Okay, the respect input signal, this is the input signal what you got it from the graph. Okay, and probably with respect to derivative controller, it's coming somewhat higher than the proportional controller, but we are not getting the exact output response of the input signal. Okay, so what happens? Intel is going outside. Proportional controller is coming like this, somewhat below this level, and proportional internal controller, it somewhat improved frequency. That means improved level of the proportional controller. Okay, so what happens from this thing? You can able to understand that proportional controller is somewhat anyway, some a huge difference is there, and the internal controller is going abnormally from the input signal, and if you come into proportional control, proportional internal controller, proportional derivative controller, it somewhat you will get the somewhat good response. Okay, then you can go for the PID controller. Then try to simulate it and you'll get the responses. Yes. So what happens? It's like the internal controller, but it now goes abnormally beyond that input level. Okay, at one instant, so you can able to find the difference. At one instant, input is coming same, output is coming same as per input signal, and somewhat light difference is there, and again it's coming to the picture. That means coming to the same frequency. Okay, there's some error, and again the error will be tuned, and again that flows in the same input level. Okay, so what happening here? So this is a response of PID controller. If we come into this for example proportional controller, only proportional controller we can able to find the difference what's is coming. Again, once again saying, explain the things. Proportional controller, try to fit it, see what's the huge difference is there. This is a proportional controller. Okay, and going for this thing, internal controller separately, there's not a derivative controller separately. There are five controllers, the proportional controller, Integral controller, proportional integral controller, proportional derivative controller, proportional integral derivative controller. There are only five controllers are there. Here I am proposing only integral controller. So we can find what response is coming. See, this response is coming. So see, this response is coming. Okay. So if you come into this side, if you're changing things, proportional derivative controller, try to simulate this thing and find out what the response is coming. Yes, since the difference is there, proportional derivative is also not giving difference, not giving the exact results. Proportional is also not giving exact result. Integral control is also not giving exact result. Proportional derivative is also not giving the exact result. Then try to check with the proportional integrative, they're giving the exact result or not. That is also not giving exact result. Since we are having a difference, so try to propose at last proposal integral in a PID controller and try to simulate this thing. Okay, you can find the difference. What is coming? Yes, you can find. Yes, at one instant is coming like this, and there's a minimum error in comparing to all the controllers. If we take all the controllers, there's a maximum error is that the error will be minimized with respect to PID controllers. Okay, that's the thing they said here. PID controller, see, proportional error, proportional constant, and that means integral constant. Okay, KI is equal to KP by JI, KD is equal to KP into D. The KPK is equal to means integral controller is equal to integral constant is equal to question proportional constant divided by S, derivative constant is equal to proportional constant into derivative factor. Okay. So here what happens, integral constant is equal to k proportional, proportional constant divided by the integral factor. Here kd is equal to derivative constant is equal to proportional constant into derivative factor. Okay, so what I am explaining this with respect to gain block. Okay, but what are things I am shown here is the controller block. Okay, first I explain one example with respect to gain block, and the remaining thing explained with respect to controller block. You can able to find what response is coming with respect to proportional controller, integral controller, and proportional derivative controller, proportional integral controller, and PID controller. So among these five controllers, we can able to find. That means for this first order system, PID controller is the best. Okay. Okay. If you come into this thing, okay, sir. So proportional controller, that's a gain block. This controller block. If you come into PI controller, we can make an attempt to the integral control separately. Here not disclose separate integral control separately. But again, what happens, first at the first axis P control using gain block controller block, you can go for the two axis separately and to try and find out what response is coming. But don't forget it, we have to utilize the value proportional constant is equal to 2 and integral constant equal to 3 and KD is equal to 0.5. What I am saying that, what are attempts made by me, okay, that this value is only okay. Proportional constant is equal to 2, integral constant is equal to 3, and derivative constant is equal to 0.5. Okay, so and coming to this is the control block. Okay, what I explained in the MATLAB 5. Coming to the second exercise, okay, MATLAB PE control using gain and integrated blocks. Okay, this is a P control proportional controller type 2 in attempt by yourself with the integral controller separately, then come to the PA controller proportional integral controller separately. Okay. Then PID controller, proportional derivative control separately, then PID control separately, and try to plot the graph for this five controllers separately, and you can able to find out what's the difference is coming between the two plots and which controller is suitable for this transfer function for this system. Okay. Okay, and probably if you go into this thing, I am again going to make an attempt for PI controller. Okay, using the with respect to gain block, the similar things you have to follow for the remaining PD controller, PID controllers, and integral controller also. If you coming here, what happens? You can able to find the KP controllers there. Okay, so try to go this thing. Okay, and remove this file. Okay, try to add one more gain. Try to add the gain frequently used blocks. Gain is there or not? Okay, gain is not there. Means gain. You can add the gain. Adding the gain, once again adding the gain because I'm using the proportional constant and derivative constant. Okay, so I'm adding the gain. Try to remove those two lines. So derivative is there. I'm adding these two things. Okay, similarly coming to here, what happens? We have to add CL plus plus. Okay, this is a function like this. So plus plus, what happens? I'm using this connecting this thing. Okay, am I using this truth function of systems? Okay. So I'm expanding the systems somewhat to this side. And then easy for to understand. Easy for you to understand. So again you have to add for 1 by s integrator. So try to find out the integrator function block here. Integrator 1 by s, yeah, ps integrator. So we can add this 1 by s integrator and then try to make an attempt with the 1 by s integrator. So what happens? Yes, I'm adding these two files. I'm adding these two as a feedback systems. Okay. Okay. So this is a gain block. As like that, you have to repeat for the internal block, proportional derivative block. What I think I made is the proportional KP. And so try to change it. This is the KP. Okay. KP is equal to, that means internal factor K is equal to Ki is equal to Kp into internal factor, 1 by internal factor. Okay. So what I am saying that here fixing the Kp is equal to 2. Okay. Here I am fixing the Kp, K is equal to 3. Okay. And then the remaining things are same. Okay. So the same thing when actually respect to controller block also. Anyway, you can have a practice of the gain block. It's easy for you. So try to run the systems. Okay. And try to find the scope. What our scope getting here is similar to that of controller block only. Okay, similar to that of controller block only. So what I am saying that here Kp is equal to 2, K is equal to 3, 1 by s, okay, plus a, the same function. This is replaced by the single controller. What I am saying that here is called as a PI controller. Okay, so here what happens, I am putting separate gain for Kp and K proportional constant, integral constant, and I'm adding one integral factors. Okay, adding y for transfer function. Okay, so similarly you have to repeat the same thing as a gain block separately and control block separately, and finding out the scope, that means output for each and every controllers, proportional controller, internal controller, proportional derivative controller, proportional internal controller, proportional derivative controller separately. Okay, and compare yourself and comment respect to this transfer function, which is the best, which controller is the best. Okay.